Make this here with all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside, when they pull up, they give me loose. Yeah, jump out, boys. That's Nike boys hopping our coast.
Taco Bell.
Thank you.
Fucking shit.
Welcome to Not Another Movie Podcast, episode number...
Big fucking surprise.
Wow.
55, I think?
56. You said 54 last week, and it was 55. Now you say 55.
We're just going to start over. We're going to reboot the podcast.
Every week it's different. We don't go in order.
Somewhere. I'm Adrian. Got Chris.
Mm-hmm.
Got Casey.
Yep.
Got Kyle. Kyle's the sleepy boy again.
Camera.
You can tell he's going to get tired halfway through this podcast.
Your camera's going to be just as good this week as it was last week.
You said you had more time to go home, so what the fuck happened?
I had to eat.
You had to go eat.
How long have you been in the car for?
My car. Let's see. I left at 7.
Been there for 2.5 hours.
Yeah, 2.5 hours.
Are you in your school parking lot right now?
No, I'm at the Taco Bell.
How long have you been in that parking lot for?
2 hours, probably.
Why? What are you doing?
I've been waiting to do this shit. I've been waiting to do this shit for an hour.
What's stopping you from going home?
Why were you in a parking lot?
Wait, could you have gone home by now?
He doesn't have a home.
So what you call a home?
You can't go to that random guy's patio anymore?
The random guy's patio is not good. Not a good spot.
It's not good.
They caught on.
Hey, I prefer my domicile right here with the air conditioning.
You don't even
know
how to spell that word.
Yeah, I'm a good speller.
All right, spell it right now.
Dude, I got in the top 20 spelling bee.
Yeah, how many were there? 19?
Spell it.
Spell it.
You got the top 20 to
E-O-M-E-C-I-L-E.
No, it's wrong. It's L-L.
Wait. No, it's bullshit. It'd be dumbest.
Cool J.
I know my fucking words. I know my words.
I didn't hear him spell it. What did he say?
He said D-U-M-B.
Shut up, you fucking...
D-U-M-B.
You fucking D-U-M-B.
You fucking dumb.
You fucking UMD video? Fuck you.
All right.
Yeah.
We're talking about movies every week.
Are we?
Yep. This week, our movie that we had to watch was Bay of Blood.
Yep.
Also,
yep.
Per extra request, Casey asked if we could watch One Cut of the Dead, because I've been putting that off for a while. So, I did that. I don't know if you guys ended up watching that or not.
I saw it way before anybody even mentioned these freaking goals, so...
Yeah, Chris watched it than I did.
Surprised you didn't bug me about that, because I feel like you would have known that's like my time.
I'm not going to bug you about anything. You don't watch shit, so I'm going to waste my time.
And then, I watched Lighthouse, and I think Chris did too.
Yeah, I did.
Cool. So we're going to watch those three, and then
Kyle
watched like 5 years ago when they were in pre-production.
Yeah, he watched it. Yeah, he was there. He played the guy that jerks off Robert Pattinson. Played the hand.
All right. But on top of that, Kyle, what else did you watch this week?
Don't fucking lie.
Yeah, don't fucking lie. Yeah, you do that all the time. I'm sick of it, dude. I'm gonna kick your ass off.
7.5 hour movie. What?
I saw that shitty fucking movie.
No, you did it.
Painful.
I don't see a shirt that says you survived it.
I hate that movie.
Well, yeah, what's it called?
Satan Tango.
No, you're a racist.
Yeah, that's totally true.
You're a racist.
All right, Kyle, what do you watch?
The only thing I watched in a theater was the stupid Jesus is King IMAX 30-minute bullshit.
That's all you watched.
Paid $12 for it. Not worth the money.
$12?
Why would you pay $12 for that? Use your fucking A-list.
I like Kanye. Why?
He's your A-list. Why are you going to give him $12?
My AMC doesn't have an IMAX. I had to go to an Edwards.
How do you have an AMC with an IMAX anywhere there?
Yeah. He lives in LA. It has like the fanciest theaters, but he doesn't have a fucking one that has IMAX.
The AMC closest to me is bare bones of shit. No bars, no Dolby, no IMAX.
Dolby.
Dolby.
Was it worth $12?
No.
I don't think anything Kanye related we were told off.
It was really pointless and like didn't matter if it was on IMAX or not. It was just more of a vanity project. Like Jesus King the album was.
Most of Kanye's music.
Yeah, so that was not
so
very
safe
good.
To say you're not a fan anymore.
No,
yeah, you hate Kanye.
I like Kanye still. And the album was better than the movie, honestly.
Gore, what'd you watch?
That means Adrian's really gonna hate it.
Yeah, I'm not gonna bother.
I watched Lighthouse. We'll talk about that, obviously. I watched Pain and Glory. It was in my theater, so I went to go see that.
Ooh.
And I really liked that. I thought that was great. Kyle said it's like the better version of Roma. And from what I understand from Roma, it seems like it's all about the family. I never watched it. I had no interest. I didn't really care. But it was all about the family in Roma, right, Kyle?
No, it was all about
the... Well, the maid was there, too. The maid was the main character, right?
She was definitely the main focus. She's
But it's still the family, right? You're following...
It's really not.
It's really not? Okay. Well, I still don't think this is exactly like Roma. I mean, besides that, it's in Spanish. Like, it's about... And it shows flashbacks of his life, but his life is way different than I would assume the maid is. Maid's life in Roma. I don't know.
The maid's a poor woman. She goes to a lot of rough places.
I know, but all those flashbacks in this movie, Pain and Glory, are very small little scenes just to fill out his backstory. It's really about where he is now more than where he was, I guess, and how it's all coming back to collide in a pretty unrealistic way, I guess, but in a way also it's well done. Not unrealistic, I should say, but it's all really
gay.
gay. It is pretty gay. It's all coincidental, like a lot of the things that happen. It's just like, oh shit, this guy is back in my life, and this happened. And, you know, it's just like, it was well done though. I really liked it.
I just think it's cool that movie's about the director himself. It's basically
the
director, and
I guess that's why it's like Roma, because that was also.
Yeah, that's why.
Okay.
He casts himself back to, you know, the good old days, you know.
Good old days.
Yeah.
Living in a cave.
And Antonio Banderas in real life is the other guy Antonio Banderas is with in the movie. So Antonio Banderas plays the director, but in real life, it's weird. But
In real life, it's weird.
In real life.
Good-ass movie.
And this explanation is...
It is a really good movie. It was really good. I really enjoyed it. Hey, go watch it.
You wouldn't understand.
You watch anything else, Core?
I watched... something. This guy. He's funny. I feel like I watched...
Anymore, you watched that... The lamest trypophobia.
Oh yeah, that one.
That was the lamest thing I've ever seen in my entire life. Yeah, and I watched it through your camera.
I watched
too.
A bunch of short horror films. That one sucked.
I didn't understand a goddamn thing that happened in that. Like plot wise, I don't understand what the fuck happened.
Yeah, I don't know. It like a bunch of really.
It's like someone got a camera and said, "Hey, people were freaked out about a bunch of holes, right? Let's put that on a woman and be funny."
Well, people are freaked out by that.
That's not even like a real phobia though. It's that
I think it is. Isn't it?
No, it's humans naturally just get like kind of creeped out by that because it resembles like a disease. Yeah, it's just like we're hardwired to like stay away from that kind of stuff.
That's why nobody likes the new iPhone camera.
Yeah, because it's like
fucking disease.
Looks disgusting.
Yeah,
but
I thought it was like a real like disorder.
Defend Apple? Hold on a second. How can anybody defend Apple? Fuck Apple.
We're not
disgusting fucking phone design.
God, here we go again.
Disgusting
another fucking bit.
Fucking disgusting earpod. Fucking. Do you see this new earpod shit they're releasing? $250 earbuds. Suck a fucking dick. Fuck you, Apple.
Yeah. Fuck
I also
you,
like how you can't say air.
Steve
correctly.
Jobs drilling out of his coffin.
I think in his grave.
I think this one's nice.
shit.
Get out of here with your fucking corporate
No,
shit.
No, the AirPod ones are nice, but the new ones are fucking weird. They look like the type that, like, the Chinese knockoffs that you find. Look all bulky
like
and, like,
fucking bell sprouts.
Yeah.
So. Weird ass design. Fuck them.
Fuck them.
All right. Casey, what'd you watch?
Apple, fuck you.
I've mostly just been... I didn't have a lot of time last week, so I was mostly just watching some more old horror movies and catching up on some shows. Nice. I am seeing, although tomorrow I'm seeing the early screening of, well, I guess it's today now, but I'm seeing the early screening of Doctor Sleep, so that'll be interesting.
Yeah, I was going to go, but I didn't.
But you're a pussy.
I have to fucking do this stupid-ass podcast, and I would have been... The video game podcast tomorrow. So.
Yeah, if Kyle's
so, can't do it.
He's a busy boy, not like you, Kyle, no. Sitting in your car for 2 hours at Taco Bell.
Yeah, that's a little weird.
Yeah, because I can afford it. So whatever.
You can afford it. The unemployed guy
can afford it. You can afford it. Stay in a car for 2 hours. That's what the homeless people say.
Hey,
they live in their cars.
That burns up gas, you know.
Sitting in your car? Is it on right now? Why would you have your car on right now?
Why not?
All right,
I mean,
whatever.
Got you there.
Whatever.
Good enough for me.
You'll take it. Good enough for me. So, you want anything else?
Not really. All
right. Out of nowhere, I just put on Space Jam and Good Burger this last week.
You're a fucking moron.
Why?
Go fuck yourself.
They both hold up all right.
Yeah, no, okay. My asshole.
Fuck you.
I haven't seen Good Burger in, like, probably 10 years, but I can still recite that entire movie.
That's the better of the two movies.
Space Jam's all right. It's got its moments.
No. What's better, diarrhea or solid turds? Something. I guess solid turds.
What's
No, I know. I just thought it was funny because I made this list of like 40 of like some of the best movies this past like 10 years, and I just threw out.
Yeah, you watch Space Jam and Good Burger,
dude. I need something to, like, kind
of
like
two of the best movies of.
Yeah,
life.
I need to offset it so I kind of know like where to gauge these movies at, you know.
Yeah.
So like when I'm watching like Manchester by the Sea, I need to know like, okay, where's the stand between Good Burger and Space Jam? Is it up there in that echelon?
It's better than Manchester. I cried during Space Jam. I didn't cry during Manchester by the Sea. So.
I did make that list, so I'm gonna start watching those after this podcast, and then I'm gonna try to squeeze in time to watch the first half of the final season of BoJack Horseman. Totally fucking missed that, but I've been busy with everything else.
Yeah, I still gotta catch up on the fourth season.
Every season of that fucking show is incredible, but it's only 6 episodes now and 6 episodes in January, so it's an easy watch. I've just had no time. Me and Chris are trying to finish Dead Space, and that's fucking a lot longer than we thought it was.
Oh,
8, 9
hours.
It's longer. No,
it's not. I'm at halfway through. I'm at 4 hours right now.
Because it's 12 chapters,
I've
right?
I've beaten that game in like 6. If you go through, if you want to get through it quick, you can get through it.
I keep thinking that, but then I look on how long to beat, and it says about 11 hours. The speed run's like 8.5 hours. And then I look up like actual other people.
A rushed playthrough is 8 hours.
And then I look through,
because the speed run's 6 hours.
And I'm looking through at everyone else, like on GameFAQs and everything else, and I was like, no, it's about 10 hours. So I don't know.
I've seen playthroughs where like people play for the first time and they finish in about 7.
I hope so. I really hope so. Because yeah, I'm on. What chapter are you on?
I'm halfway through chapter 7. I have 4 hours and like 8 minutes.
Yeah, we're like at the exact same pace right now. So I hope we finish that. I'm assuming that we're like right there. Unless
I mean,
like
at
last
point,
two chapters.
It doesn't matter because I've watched playthroughs of that game so many times.
Okay.
So I already know exactly.
As long as the last like couple chapters aren't fucking long as shit, but that's been my last week trying to finish that up. And then yeah, I watched the 3 movies that we're gonna talk about in a second. Speaking of, before we get to trailers later on, you guys watched the Grudge trailer?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll
the what?
The Grudge and then
The Grudge, yeah.
Mandalorian. You guys go ahead and talk about those. I haven't seen those, but I mean, I wouldn't really have anything to contribute to them. I did watch the Antler one. Put those in there.
Okay.
All right. Let's start with The Lighthouse. I kind of want to talk about that right now.
Okay.
Yeah. Nice quick little podcast, hopefully. Knock on wood. All right. Kyle, you're the one that fucking started raving about this, so you start us off.
Aye, you're fond of me lobster, aren't you?
I love that part.
Fucking best part.
That part where he gets really insulted that Robert Pattinson doesn't like his food.
Yeah.
He's just like, he's just like, you're like me lobster, right? And he's just like, no.
Why you fucking bastard? You like me?
Hey, it goes on that Neptune. Yeah, Neptune strike you down. It goes on for like 5 minutes about what the fuck would happen. He's like, all right, shit. It's like,
nah. I love that movie, and I've been thinking about it a lot. It's just, I think it's just a really fucking fun movie. Honestly,
did you watch it one time or twice? Two times.
I've seen it once, and I do want to see it twice. It's at the AMC near me, and I'm definitely going to see it twice.
It's not a movie you watch once.
Oh, God, no.
Yeah, sure. But what I just find fascinating or, like, really enjoyable about it is that it's basically just two fucking college dorm fucking fuck boys, and, you know,
they're just getting
drunk. Sure. And that is basically the experience of being in a dorm room with another drunk. Sure.
Your experience is your roommate farting. Is always running around naked and constantly masturbating.
If it was in the 1800s,
this is a fucking mermaid.
Hey, anyways,
mermaid vagina.
I really like that movie. Has a lot of very memorable moments, and just overall, I really enjoyed it.
All right, Casey, what do you think?
Like I said last week, I love that movie. It was real. It got extremely fucking weird at times, but it was still really enjoyable. The thing I loved the most was just any time just William Dafoe just started going on one of his fucking monologues.
Yeah.
Is this me or I can't recognize William Dafoe in there.
No, you can't tell it's him most of the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I couldn't tell it was Robert Pattinson either, to be fair. Because, you know.
Yeah.
Acting.
I'm glad he
I'm not used to great acting.
I'm so glad
anymore.
I'm
used to Annabelle.
I'm so glad he just took that Twilight money and he's just like, fuck it, let's do some good shit now.
Yeah.
Good times.
He's been doing that pretty much since the last fucking Twilight movie. Like, where the last Twilight movie came out and then immediately the Cronenberg movie. And it's like,
yeah.
Which wasn't very good. I didn't like it. But
three off my head is Good Time, High Life, and Lighthouse with him.
Yeah, I mean, but he had some really good ones and nobody saw. The Rover I thought was really good and nobody saw that.
City of Z?
Yeah, nobody saw that.
I hated that movie.
Yeah, he hated that one because
he looked at it.
Yeah, I hate it.
He's just like, I'm bored.
Yeah,
where's Iron Man?
The slowest burn, worth for nothing.
Fuck off.
Hey, it wasn't as good as Chad Astor. So
exactly.
Chad Astor.
And Brad Pitt's a Chad. So.
The Dad Astor, that's what everybody calls it.
But, Chris, what do you think?
No, it sucked.
Alright.
didn't like the mermaid.
Stupid. They couldn't even get the picture right. It was like a box. What was going on?
What the fuck?
Crank up the... Where's the color?
Fuck your artistic integrity.
Where the color at, you dumb fuck? Jesus, don't they notice not 1920 anymore?
No.
Fucking, what the fuck? Yeah, where's the Technicolor? Anyway, no, I thought it was a fine movie.
I thought it was just okay.
It was whatever. I don't know. I kind of like the last Halloween movie better. This is a bad Halloween movie this year. I
hate this remake.
Yeah. No, I'm talking about, like, there's no horror movies ever that come out in October, and I would consider this a horror movie, for sure. It's pretty fucking brutal at times, too. No, I loved it. I thought it's in my top 10, easily. Probably in my top 5. I was really excited for it, to the point where I would say it was, like, my most anticipated movie of, like, the last part of this year, which is a lot of shit coming out. It was even higher than, like, Joker and shit. I was really excited for it. Like Kyle said, it was a fun time. That was a fun movie. It's one of those movies where it has the black humor.
It was a good time.
I love.
Yeah,
get it, because Robert Pattinson. But it was a great time. It really was. It was a fun movie. My theater was loving it too. I was surprised that
my theater loved it.
My theater loved it.
When he fell, And my theater, yeah. Like, oh! I don't know why my theater fucking blew out like that.
Yeah, well, because that part was just, like, weird. All right. Oh, you talk about when he fell from the lighthouse.
Yeah, when they're like, when he's like, painting it.
Okay. At the end, when he fell, because everybody was like, what the fuck is going on? And then he fell down the stairs. You're like, whoa! And then you see the last, like, fucking shot. I was like, goddamn. But yeah, no, it was great. It was a great, great time. It was an excellent film altogether. It was beautiful to look at and disturbing.
Yeah.
And you know what? I will say this. I wish there was more mermaid vagina. Anyway, that's my review.
I agree 100%.
Two thumbs up.
And I'm going to bring some to the theater next time.
Would you call me?
I'm gonna bring some tissues into the theater next time.
Oh yeah, because it was like I was really sad when some things happened. Nah, he's making a dick.
Sicko mode.
I switched around. He was making a cum joke, and I switched around.
Yeah, he wants to jerk off when he sees dead seagulls. He's really got a fucked up ring.
That seagull, he grabbed it and just starts stabbing.
Fuck you.
That went on for like 5 seconds too long, and then it went 5 seconds longer than that, which made it even funnier.
He was so mad at that fucking seagull.
It was funny. It stopped being funny, but it went so long that it started being funny again.
I love when things do that. It definitely went a little bit too much, but then it was
hilarious.
But then it kept going after that. I was like, oh my god.
That seagull was a fucking dick. He deserved that shit.
Right.
Fucking coming up with his one eye looking like an asshole. He's like, fuck this fucking piece of shit. fucking hit him like 12 times against the fucking...
I was in a rush because I had a lot of stuff to do today, so I watched it right after work and I was delirious and tired, which made the movie even like fucking more insane. Like, I feel like I was like kind of zoned out for like a quarter second and then something fucking insane happens and I was like, did I just miss a fucking like half an hour of the movie? I swear to God I did. I looked at my phone and I'm like, it's been like a minute.
He zone out for a few seconds and you come back in. Wait, why is Willem Dafoe naked again?
Yeah, no, I
you zone out for a few seconds and then Willem Dafoe says, yeah, this happened. I'm like, no, it didn't. What the fuck?
Yeah, no. It was because like there's those movies where I'm delirious, but I zone out into the point where like I'm like not paying attention. I'm kind of falling asleep. This one, like, yeah. I was zoning out, like, but kind
of
like
City of Z.
Yeah, that one's fucking snooze fest. This one though, I was like zoning out, but like to the point where I was getting as delirious as they were in it, where I'm just like freaking out. I'm like, what the fuck is happening? But because of that though, I feel like it wasn't like as thorough of a viewing that I wanted to. So I'm gonna watch it again soon. I loved it. Like, I still loved it. Had a fucking amazing time with it. And I know that's gonna be somewhere on my top 10 list. It isn't right now, but I don't know on my second viewing it'll 100% be there somewhere. I just want to kind of. It feels like with that director, I feel like I just need a second viewing with it, just kind of dissect it a little bit more than I.
This one, I needed less of a second viewing from than I think The Witch. The Witch was just like, it ended on a moment where I was just like, what the fuck? I need to watch it again.
That's exactly that's what I thought of the last scene of this one, though.
No. At the end of this one, I was just like, there is a deeper meaning to it, but I didn't end it like, I need to see all the clues. I was just like, yeah.
Did you guys get Shining or 2001 vibes from it at some point?
Oh, yeah, totally. I get a lot of Fincher vibes, some Lovecraftian shit going on a little bit from some of the visuals. Even Edgar Allan Poe a little bit.
Yeah. When he gets that first night when he starts seeing tentacles everywhere, I'm like, this year going to get really weird or fucking Cthulhu better pop up.
Yeah. That was the one thing I would say. The only negative in this, I feel like they showed too much of him going crazy a little too quick. Because, like, I felt like it was, like, first 10 minutes immediately he has, like, a fucking weird-ass dream immediately.
See, that was the fucking exact moment where I swear to God where I was like, no. I'm saying that's the exact moment where I zoned out in, like, the first 10 minutes, and then that happened. And I swear to God, I was like, did I miss a lot of this fucking movie? Because this guy's already freaking out right now.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what my problem. Fuck.
It wasn't like I was like, what the fuck's going on? It was more like, oh, okay, we're already getting into him fucking losing
Yeah, because they said what, he was on the lighthouse island for, like, what, 5 weeks at some point?
Four weeks. He's supposed to be on it for 4 weeks. They stand there, wait for the thing to pick them up, never shows up. The whole thing is that it could be less time. It's just them going fucking insane.
Yeah, I think they need to extend that. They need to, like, thematically extend it a little bit longer because maybe it's just me, but I think 4 weeks to, like, lose your mind that fucking...
But he starts losing mind in the first few days.
Well, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It's not even the first few days. It's like he gets there... He gets there, goes to his bed, immediately finds the mermaid statue, and starts going insane. And that's within, like, 20 minutes of him arriving on the island.
And I get why.
It's him arriving, going, hey, here's your bed. What's the statue? Oh, shit, I'm seeing shit now.
Yeah, and I guess Willem Dafoe does kind of put it into his mind, like, because the other guy that used to work there was, like, seeing shit. He was saying, like, mermaids and fucking sirens and shit. So, I guess him finding the mermaid statue, that makes sense because the guy was kind of losing his shit with mermaids. And like I just, him having a dream about a mermaid is fine, but the dream was fucked up. It was like something you'd see from somebody that's almost has completely lost their mind.
Yeah, no, so I agree. I think they should have.
If you just saw a mermaid, it was like, hey, what's up, bro? I'm a mermaid. You know?
The movie needed to be a little bit more slower just to kind of like get it to that point, but I'm not complaining. It was still.
Oh, no, no, no. That's like the only negative I have.
No, I agree with you, though. I think that was my negative as well.
Well, my only other negative is that there could have been more scenes of them dancing and
oh, dude, when they start, when they're almost going to kiss, hey, push it there.
Yeah. And then they start fighting. So good. Hey, what, Kyle?
That, I was going to bring that scene up because it was fucking hilarious.
It was great. That whole scene. Like, it was so. How many times they go from being chummy to fucking just wanting to kill each other? It's like, there's like five times
that happens. Hey, that's a real bromance right there. That's a real
bromance.
Yeah, you want to kiss each other, then you punch each other.
Yeah, and then you stab one in the head, and then the other one you fall down and get your guts eaten out by seagulls.
And then you leash him up like a dog and then walk him around like a fucking.
Yeah, that was fun.
like fucking Channing Tatum, and this is the end.
Oh, yeah. He's like, hey, what's up, guys?
Hey,
I call him Channing Tate Yum.
Underrated funny moment.
Willem Dafoe.
When Willem Dafriend, when fucking Robert Pattinson is shoveling the dirt onto him, and Willem Dafoe just like keeps.
Yeah, that was great. He's having another monologue, except he has the dirt being spilled on him. So good. So, and he's doing a great job, too, because they have to shovel the dirt on him, and there could have been a time where they fucked up and just, like, put the dirt way too much in his mouth.
They did sometimes, though.
And it's some, and he's like, he's like, anyway, back to the monologue. It's like, that's why I think he should get an Oscar nomination for that. Like, Robert Pattinson was great, don't get me wrong, and I hope he does, too, for something, but I would, if I had to pick from either Robert Pattinson or Willem Dafoe, I think Willem Dafoe should definitely get that nomination and then lose to Joaquin Phoenix. So... Actually, I would be perfectly fine with it. You know what? I would love if Willem Dafoe won, not because I think his performance is better. I think it's like on par. I would say.
One second.
But Joaquin Phoenix is like, that's fine. All right, well, that's just a stop. I'll just wait until he comes back. I want him to hear my point.
I was gonna say, you know, he's been nominated.
No, nobody talk until he comes back.
Oh.
Oh my god, let's just do memes until he comes back. Yeah, let's just do memes until he comes back. This is like the ad break, except we're just gonna say memes.
Say memes.
Here's a 7-Eleven.
I'm gonna describe this meme for you.
Yeah, you know the one with the dog, and he's like, wow, amazing.
Wow. You know?
Anyway, wait, what about 7-Eleven?
I want an M&M's ice cream bar right now.
Oh, is that what was the 7-Eleven thing you want to talk about?
Yeah, I want ice cream.
Are you okay?
I want ice cream. I want ice cream.
It's a shame you're not in a car and could drive somewhere where you could get ice cream.
That's not very podcast friendly.
Yeah, as the last
one. Yeah, neither was you dropping your phone like 6 times last week or going to take a piss and being gone for 15 fucking minutes.
Right. At this point, I already forgot my point, so when he comes back, I'm not going to be able to get back to it.
Talk about Willem Dafoe and Oscars.
Who? We were talking about Spider-Man and Edge of Tomorrow, right? What was it called? What was the last one called?
Edge of Tomorrow?
Edge of Time. That was one of the games. What are we talking about? Spider-Man Shattered Dimensions?
Talking about great Spider-Man.
Game. No, we were talking about Spider-Man Friend or Foe.
Oh, Friend or Foe. I love that one, too.
Friend or Foe is a bad one.
Yeah, no, it's not very good.
It's like X-Men Legends for dipshits.
It's for fucking little babies. That's what it's for.
Well, fucking.
What about how great Spider-Man 3 was?
Oh, that one's great.
Spider-Man 3, the game, was fucking dog shit. I just reuse the same fucking web-slinging system, man. It's bullshit.
Why not? It was Treyarch that made the original. Well, not the original. The second game.
Yeah. I think they made the first one too, right?
They probably did, but no one gives a fuck about the first one.
The first one's kind of okay.
It's fine. It's not well, open no, world.
The first one was good, but it just it wasn't what everyone was hoping for, but they didn't have the technology at the time.
Or yeah. They didn't have enough time to do it.
Yeah, they have shit.
All right, what
moves
did you get?
The only reason everyone hates the first is because as soon as you touch the ground, no matter how gentle it is, you fucking you snap your ankles and your broken bones go flying into your fucking chest and kill you.
Fogs.
Fogs? Is that what you just said?
Yeah, there's a bunch of fog.
Well, no, that's the PS1 game. Idiot.
Adrian!
Hey, what's up, man? Anyway, Willem Dafoe, I'd be okay if he won because Willem Dafoe is like 80 and he doesn't have many other opportunities to get an Oscar.
I think he should have probably had it.
He was
for
pretty
the Florida
spry
project.
In this. He should have, but that was a supporting actor. I think this would be best actor.
Yeah.
He got nominated last year as well.
For the Vincent Van Gogh one, right?
Yeah.
Or Picasso. I don't know. Yeah, that one. But he didn't win, obviously. And this time, I think he should. I mean, I love Joaquin Phoenix. I thought he was great, and I think his role is just as good as this one. But he's like what 40-something. He has time, unless he dies suddenly. That would be
I wish
keep alive. I like I said, Willem Dafoe is 80 and he'll die soon. You're fine with that, but Joaquin Phoenix might die.
So the way you said it, though, the way you said it, like, well, I guess he might still watch out.
He might. Everybody could die. Watch out.
The idea that, like, William Dafoe has been, like, cursed by a witch to live forever until he wins an Oscar. And, like, once he finally wins, like, the Oscar, you'll see him walk up on stage, touch it, and then, like, fucking Thanos just turn to dust instantly, like, the second he touches it.
Fucking flies away. Oscar's still there. Poor guy. Anyway, Willem Dafoe, I thought he was terrific. I thought he was great. Every monologue was amazing, and I'm sad that he died in the movie. When that happened, I was like, oh no, not Willem.
Not Willem.
Not Willem the friend.
Not Willem. Willem the friend. Anyway.
It was an awesome time. I just loved any scene that was obviously out of place, like when he pulls up the Willem Dafoe's head.
Oh, yeah,
it's like
yeah,
it freaks
yeah.
him out and then just back to somewhere else already again.
Yeah. Because, I mean, there's the
first jerk off scene where he's like, oh, what was that on the ground? That. I cleaned it. No, it's there. I swear I cleaned it. You're going to clean it again.
Going to clean it again, Winslow. And then he says, like, I want you, if I tell you to fucking take all these boards out, rip out the nails, fucking suck them clean and put them back together and then do it again, you'll fucking do it. That whole monologue.
Then there's also what he got. I love the part where he got, where Robert Pattinson got slightly freaked out in that dream where he's dealing with the mermaid, William Dafoe, holding a cage with like his previous whatever guy's name was, his fucking severed head in a fucking cage.
Right.
It's just like Robert Pattinson's like a little panicky about it, but not really. I'm like, oh, okay. No, like even insane, you'd think someone would freak out a bit more than just, oh, that's not good.
All right, I guess if it's a dream, then. I mean, I've had fucked up dreams. I don't wake up from them going, well, I guess I'm a fucking insane murderer now.
Yeah. All right, where's the axe?
Where is it? Where's Willem Dafoe? I'm coming.
Tweet that right now.
I'm insane now.
Where are you? I'm coming.
He just joined Twitter today. Immediately gets threatened.
From Gore the Movie God.
From this guy.
Or
yeah, Kyle, that's the thumbnail. It's Gore like this and say, "Watch out, Willow."
Watch out, Will.
He makes a Twitter and goes fucking OJ with it. Just starts threatening people right off the bat.
Oh, OJ, what? I don't want his head.
OJ. Oh no.
Oh no.
I can't believe no one's brought up the best line in the movie though.
Which one?
I want to fuck a steak.
I had a steak right now.
Yeah.
I'd fuck it.
Yeah.
I was going to bring it out of my theater. I was going to bring it up earlier because I was the one that everybody in my theater fucking. There was one guy in front of me who fucking, like, it was like the moment in the Beach Bum where I, Martin Lawrence talked about like feeding cocaine to his cocaine addicted parrot, where I fucking lost my fucking mind and I couldn't stop laughing. That was pretty much that guy for that scene. He's like, I had a steak, and there's like a good long like 2-3 second pause.
What to fucking say?
Because he's so hungry, he just wants a steak, bro. If he saw a steak right now, he'd be like, I gotta fuck it first.
I don't think he was hungry. I think he was horny.
No, I know he won. True. Yeah, he was a little horny, but yeah, he wanted some good food. He wanted fucking slop.
Wait, hold on.
I never liked the scene where he threw out the shit and it just flew in his face.
Yeah. and then Willem Dafoe, you smell like shit. Like, yeah, it's not just mine, asshole. That's good shit.
Also, this movie has more fart jokes than the new Adam Sandler movie.
Yo, there's a poop joke in like the first 5 minutes.
Yeah.
He walks in, you just hear him pooping.
Yep. Yeah, he did some raps.
Yeah, man, he farted.
Oh, yeah. You smell, everything about you smells, and your farts.
You fucking,
I hate your font. Fuck!
He said.
Very good.
Hey, the only thing I would change about this movie is the ending. I think it should have ended when he put his hand in the fire and he was just like fucking screaming hysterically. And there's like that static noise. That's like the only thing you can hear.
Yeah, when he screams, it's like a muffled, like static scream.
Yeah, that was fucking awesome.
I like where it ended because it was just like. It was a fucked up visual end on. Yeah. And also it's like, you know, you think about it like, oh, it's a seagull and now he's has one eye and he's getting eaten by a seagull. It's just like you can get a deeper meaning from that if you really want. But I was just like, look at this fucking fucked up visual.
Seagulls are getting revenge for their fallen brother.
Yeah. Who he has one eye now, just like their seagull brother. It was the same eye too. It's like, there you go. I guess you could say because they talk about earlier where like Willem Dafoe, and this is a real thing, where it's like seagulls are like the souls of like sailors that passed away.
Past sailors.
Yeah, so it's unlucky to kill one, and he kills one that has one eye, and then later on
immediately the fucking storm shit happens.
Yeah, immediately the storm, like the winds turned west, and Willem Dafoe's like, "What the fuck's going on?" And he's like, "I don't know, man. That's weird." Oh, that's fucking.
What did seagulls?
Yeah, I didn't do that. he puts it behind his back. He's like, "I didn't do it."
I didn't do that. One seagull holds up a dead seagull.
Yeah, it's barely a seagull anymore. It looks like a fucking wet towel. It's like, fuck. Dude, he slammed it so much the wings started falling off.
Dude, that was a fucked up visual when you see the overhead of the seagull that fell in there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With all just fucking just goop.
Yeah. To be fair, he didn't kill that seagull, though.
Nah, but
he killed the other one.
Killed the shit out of it. Did he?
Yeah. And that seagull did attack him.
Yeah, I think that's fair.
I mean, that's self-defense.
Stupid.
It was self-defense for about seven or eight seconds.
He could easily hit it once, and it would probably die, but it would have been like, yeah. Like, yeah, there you go. Teach
he
you.
He said he had to go sicko mode.
He went sicko. He enjoyed
said,
that
if
shit.
If he said, I'm going to go sicko mode on you and then kill him, movie of the year.
In that accent,
like, fuck,
too?
Fuck every other movie I saw this year. That was
mean accent.
I kid you not, if he did that, I would have got up and left the theater because that would have been just...
I don't need to see it anymore. Like, it's a perfect
done.
Movie. I'm going
to
watch
any
it.
Any more movies. This is it. I'm done.
That's my deathbed movie. It's perfect.
Fuck anything that Endgame had in it. Like, that's the best moment.
They work 10 years. I waited 11 years
for that scene.
Yeah, but then you wait all this time and you got the cool scenes, all this high budget, but no, it's Robert Pattinson saying, I'm going to go sicko mode on you and kill a fucking bird. All right. You win.
And not even kill a bird, fucking destroy it. Like, I'm surprised that motherfucker didn't turn into dust by how many times. He hit that motherfucker.
Yeah, he goes
smush into fucking like paste. I was like, goddamn.
Anything else? Anyone else want to say on the movie before we move on?
I thought everything was great about it. I really did. Like everything.
I fucking love A24, dude.
Technical about it is great.
A24 is so fucking good with these kind
of
movies.
Even though they released one of the worst movies this year, you're right.
What movie?
They released
Souvenir.
The Letter remake. Wait, what movie?
The Souvenir.
Oh, he didn't like that movie. But everybody liked that movie besides...
No one likes that movie. They're liars.
That's a 98%
of Rotten Tomatoes. They're lying to you.
I don't know. It has a 90%. I think it has a 90% or something.
Hey, 824 has like four movies in my top 10. So, you know, kudos to them.
Yeah, kudos to them.
Kudos to you. Your movies suck, but kudos to you.
All right, moving on.
Yeah. The Lighthouse. Go fuck
fucking stuff. Awesome.
Go fuck it and then a steak.
Yeah, go fuck a steak.
All right, on that
I want to see that Halloween costume. I want to see a Halloween costume of Robert Pattinson with the steak stapled to your crotch. I want to see a staple, too. Go fucking hardcore, bro.
There you go.
And bring if I don't see a staple, hardcore. Then fuck you. You didn't do it well.
I'm going to put that as a timestamp, so if anyone's trying to actually look for the Bay of Blood, they're just here. if there's no staple, fuck you.
All right. We're going to talk about Bay of Blood now?
Yeah, let's talk about that, because I want to leave one cut of the dead for the end.
Okay, good.
All right, Bay of Blood. Talk about this one for a little bit, Casey. Why did we watch this? I know we talked about it last week,
I tried to avoid spoilers. But with that, it was, like I said, it's not so much watching it because it's going to be scary, but it came out in 1971, so that was before John Carpenter and all that stuff, before all the 80s came around. Mario Bava is well known for his low-budget Italian, I'd say horror movies, but it's some of it is a bit, it's more for like a thriller or drama type.
Right.
But like, this is, it's something, you know, it's a movie that not a lot of people have watched. And yet, if you ask a lot of horror directors about it, like all of them have seen it. And you can see from the cinematography, too, just how influential it is on horror movies, because this is, like, there's a ton of stuff that's introduced. This introduced, like, the killer POV shots we never had before that. A bunch of the cliches with the killing sexually active teenagers, the stupid, you know, the person that's too stupid to be a murderer is the murderer and stuff like that. And like I said, there's things that are taken straight out of that, like Chris, I think you probably notice it with that first suicide when the woman kills herself.
Mm-hmm.
Like the camera sped up and shaking every time I see that shot reminds me heavily of the transformations from The Thing with what they do with the camera. There's the spear kill, which I think it was. I always forget. I think that was Halloween. I think it was Friday the second Friday the 13th. They did that with.
Bed killing you.
Yeah. So it's like you can see just how heavily it influenced. And then it's like when the sister comes down the stairs, the two scenes, they're mirrored of each other both times she comes down, whereas the same shot's going to her brother's room or her husband's room.
Right.
It's just, that's why. It's just such, it's not necessarily scary, but it's so influential that it's worth watching just to see it.
Kyle, what'd you think of it?
It was cool. I like Yala movies a lot, so it was definitely up my alley. And I was really happy to see it. Mario Bava, I've been wanting to watch a lot of his movies for a while now, and I think this is a pretty good introduction. And what a Yala movie is, it's just any kind of Italian exploitation movie, and there's a lot of really cool camera shots and stuff, like all the POV shots and the
this one is a very cinematic with him. It's very cinematic. Like there were quite a few shots in this where it was just, you forget it's a horror movie because he just gets these beautiful sweeping landscape shots just thrown in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very colorful.
A lot of them too.
Yeah.
Some would say maybe about 40 minutes too much of it.
ooh, we got a hot take.
I'm just saying, yeah. I read the backstory of this where he wanted to film something really quick and cheap. So
oh yeah, this is probably, I think this is actually his cheapest movie he did, and all of his movies were fucking cheap, so
yeah, it looks it.
But even that, it's still one of his best.
So on that note, Chris, what
would
you think then?
I didn't like it. I really didn't like it, actually. I thought it was really fucking boring. And I thought the kills were great. And I thought the cinematography was really nice. I thought it was really cool how they used zooms and stuff. They used a lot of it, just fucking pop zooms, like every I would say 30 seconds there was like a
right
over here. Zoom.
Yeah. All
right, move over here. I mean, it's cool. Gives it the it makes it feel like it's kind of like a one take too.
And also in that time, that was a real popular thing to do with those.
Yeah, yeah, movies. I know. Yeah, Suspiria does it too a lot. It's just I didn't like anything about it besides the more common horror.
I can appreciate stuff. The legacy of it.
And I've heard of this movie for a long time. Every horror channel on YouTube, I follow a lot of them. They always talk about this fucking movie. And I was just like, go ahead, sneeze. So he's driving now. A lot of changes are happening. But there's a... you sneezing, him driving.
Crazy, man.
I'm not used
new
to
new year,
this.
New Gore. But,
yeah. But anyway, so I didn't hate it, but it was just like I watched it on YouTube. It was just on YouTube, obviously. He sent it, but it was just like it was fine. It was a fine little movie. I didn't really like it, but I didn't hate it. It was just like a 5 out of 10. I could see the influence, obviously. I've heard of the influence. I've heard of it so much I never really wanted to watch it, but I'm glad I did. I'm glad I watched it. It's 80 minutes. I thought the ending was hilarious. And that's
yeah,
that's
dude. It. Okay. Okay.
It's fucking great.
Okay.
Ending is fucking fantastic.
So me
it's like the Lighthouse level of amazing.
So
cuz to be honest, I forgot those characters even fucking existed in the movie cuz they showed them like twice
before. Yeah, that's the one thing. It's like everyone that's seen it is like at the ending goes to shit, but for some reason that makes the movie so much better cuz it just goes to fucking shit in the last 15 minutes. You're just fucking chaos.
Yeah, right. And I do like, I should say this before we get to the ending. I know you want to say something. I did really like the music, too. There's a lot of drum stuff. Yeah. There's a lot of like violin, like fucking exactly what you expect from a horror movie nowadays, too, where you have like the loud-ass violin playing whenever there's a jump scare. But I thought they did it pretty well because a lot of times there wasn't too much music being played.
They kick you out of that parking lot or what?
Yeah, they told them to get the fuck out of here.
Fucking, saw the cops rolling up.
It's just like, the
second we talk about the stupid other movie, I'm out.
Give me your app.
I'm going to go somewhere for a minute.
He wants to get ice cream. He pulled up somewhere
to
get ice cream.
You don't want to talk about One Cut of the Dead?
Yeah, because I didn't watch it.
Oh, you missed out.
Wow, you've only had a month. And it's a movie I know you'd enjoy. That's a real shame.
Yeah, you would like it, I think. Sure. Anyway, sorry, we'll talk about it in a second. Cora, go ahead.
Okay. But yeah, no, I like the music, and I like that it was minimal, but I also don't like it at the same time, because there's so many times where it's just like watching characters walk around. I was just like, nothing happening. You hear forest noises, and whatever. You know, you're
I thought Kyle might like it. I thought Adrian might. With you, being honest with you, I didn't think you'd like it, but I think you were at least appreciate some of that.
Yeah, I appreciate it. I appreciate it.
So
yeah, I appreciate it. I get the influential stuff. I do, but I feel like when you look right at it, there's only a few things that really went into the other slashers that became much more popular than this. And even stuff like, I mean, I this one's more influential because it's extremely violent. And of course the sex and stuff. When it comes right down to it, like stuff like Psycho was definitely more influential to the slasher horror movies. Cause Psycho is pretty much a slasher movie. It's fun. It's whatever. It didn't bother me. Watching this compared to watching like, oh,
Audition.
Jacob's Ladder. No, I liked Audition. But Jacob's Ladder and shitty horror movies I saw this year. Even like, not even horror movies. What's the fucking, the Mads Mikkelsen one? Polar.
Like, I'd rather watch God, this. I forgot about that.
I don't think it was a waste of time. Also, I also really liked the head and with the octopus. That was a good visual.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. There was a couple moments that actually creeped me out. That one creeped me out. I was like, ooh. Like, it's a good visual, I guess. Anyway, that's it.
It didn't really stick with me.
Yeah.
It's because I also don't have the legacy.
You don't watch too many slashers,
yeah,
though,
right? Yeah, so I don't have the legacy of it. But, like, I could... It's...
That might be interesting for you to watch the other ones now after watching this, though.
Yeah, and I do... I am going to. I did order the documentary.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But, Yeah, no, like I still like I saw what was going on, but it just didn't age well at all. I don't think. I think, especially doing logical jumps and the how far horror has come since then, and just how tired some tropes are. Obviously, like I mean, I get that it originated, but like those tropes, not even just because they got originated there, don't mean I necessarily still care about them. Like, I don't know why that girl ran off on her own. Even though, like,
yeah, I don't know why a lot of characters.
Even though both those dudes were like all up on her, like literally 2 seconds prior to that, more than the fucking blonde chick, they were on that girl.
And they're all fucking dead. Yeah. Who cares?
Yeah, and I don't understand like the thought process behind everyone killing each other. Like sometimes some I of did. Some
I will.
Of the
I,
didn't
I will
make
say
sense
that. Yeah, the overall the plot I guess makes sense.
Well, yeah, right? It makes sense because basically whoever way. Was left alive is the one that can get a hold of the land.
Yeah, the shitty fucking bay that sucks. At least the one the business guy made sense because he wanted to just take it and fucking turn it into I don't know a mall
a
or some shit. Yeah, a resort, whatever. Yeah. I didn't care. But like at least that made sense. But like everybody else is just like it's a fucking shitty moat. And like who gives a fuck? I mean, it looked nice, I guess. But like murdering people for it, I was just like, I don't know. It's like I guess the twist is you have to even consider a twist. Like I immediately was like, yeah, okay, just a whatever. But I don't know them killing.
No, the
people
ending
and stuff.
Was fucking hilarious. That
yeah, that ending's hilarious.
That was the like, greatest fucking.
Hey,
thing.
Mommy. Oh my god, they're both dead. It's like bye, we're done. funny. That's a funny ending.
Yeah, no, that ending was like that
one. Kyle, you like that ending?
Yeah.
That's how you know it's good.
If you're not gonna input anything and you're not gonna care about the plot of One Cut of the Day, you should probably go get the ice cream now and then hear us talk about it so you maybe get convinced to watch it.
We're still talking about Bay of Blood.
Hey, what else do you gotta say about it, Kyle?
I don't want him. I think
I liked it, but also I'm just more, knowledge in the Yalo genre. Yalo. So, you know, for me, this is pretty,
I've never heard people pronounce it Yalo, though.
Huh?
I've never heard people pronounce it as Yalo.
That's the fucking pretentious fuckboy, like, proper yeah. ways.
Which, yeah. I'm sure that's the way you pronounce it, but I never
that's
heard
That's the way Italian.
I heard Jallo.
Yallo.
Yeah, but they don't. They speak weird.
Yeah, exactly.
Those weird Italians.
I mean, once you hear it for real, then you're not going to say Yallo.
Gallo.
I still love Yallo. These movies end up getting sneaking onto YouTube, even though there's like full nudity in them.
That girl, you're allowed, that was great. There's
rules. You can as long as it's not like if it's not like it's basically
obviously
sex, they're lenient with it.
But as long as not obviously pornographic.
That sex had penetration in it.
Yeah, like the post.
Yeah, that's the joke I was making. Thank you.
Oh, little penetration popping. Oh.
Like a more like a back thing. Well, it went through her back. I don't get it.
Let's see.
This guy's weird.
Yeah, no, I was able to appreciate it, but
no,
it was not say I didn't
more
really
I talk
enjoy
about it.
It
the more
also,
I don't,
also,
like...
so just want to point out, fucking everyone in that fucking movie is fucking hot as hell.
Sure.
Yeah,
for
especially
like,
the
some of them are like the older guys.
Crunchy old men.
Yeah, crunchy.
It's fucking crunchy, bro. Okay, just put them in my mouth.
That skin they got, that foreskin, it's probably pretty crunchy.
You're so retarded. It's just like not even.
Hey, what the fuck? What's wrong with
regret I'm going to edit that out.
I'm going to edit that out.
No, don't edit it out. Put it in more times. Keep adding it.
Raise the volume.
All right, Kyle, repeat your lines. You can edit that out.
I'm sorry. Mentally retarded. There you go. That's okay.
I did an IQ 2 test today, so I don't want to hear it.
I did IQ.
You made a haiku?
Yeah, I did an IQ. If every 575, I'm going to kill you.
I don't want to hear it, so I did it today, so I don't want to hear it. All
right.
Okay. Did you do that in your car while you waited 2 hours before the podcast?
No.
What'd you do? Are you talking about? What'd you do in your car? I still want to know. Would you just wait here 2 hours? Just like the Terminator, just waiting for your target?
Just
like blank stare?
Looked at Twitter, looked at Letterboxd, the usual shit I do.
for 2 hours in a car in a front of a Taco Bell
for no reason. Hours goes when you're doing jack shit.
He doesn't have a home. He doesn't have a home.
Oh, you're so mad.
I'm mad that you're homeless. I'm so upset.
Listen, I did my IQ test today. I don't want
to. I don't give a fuck about your IQ.
All right, well, that was Bay of Blood.
What was his score, Kyle?
Oh, they wanted money, so I didn't give it to them.
I didn't even know. Like, I like he said it like, oh, yeah, I'm smart. I did IQ test today. I don't even know the fucking results. Like, I know I got them, right?
65.
That's pretty good, right?
Yeah, that's a passing grade.
It's like Forrest Gump level. That's great.
Yeah.
Good job.
That's a passing grade.
Forrest Gump went places. He shook hands with JFK and all that.
I'm pretty sure if you're 80, you actually can be. You are mentally retarded.
So
I'm not 80. They're actually like 65 or under. Yes.
That
I would love if you meant the. I would love if you meant the age. If you're 80, you just turn mentally retarded.
I thought 100 was average.
Anyway, Bay of Blood.
A lot of retards out there.
All right, now edit that one out. That one's offensive.
Oh, okay.
I'm
a lot of this out, Kyle.
It's fine calling you retarded because you are.
You're a lot of this out, Kyle.
And we're not saying you are. We mean like according to the state of California, you are.
Yeah, so I have to call you that. But now you call other people retarded. That's
all this bullshit I have to hear today.
I don't know, man.
What did I do to deserve this? What? I just want
to set your car in front of the Taco Bell for 2 hours.
I want to talk to with my friends, and I have to.
You didn't even see One Cut of the Dead.
So what?
You want to talk movies? I come in and see one of the movies we were talking about.
I don't care.
You had 2 hours in your car. You could have watched it then.
Yeah, you can watch it on your phone. Load up Shutter. It's a free trial.
Yeah, I don't fucking know. Adrian was gonna fucking be painting his nails all fucking night, so I don't watch that.
Yeah, Adrian, I hate when you do that. Just painting your nails all day.
Wait, but also, why didn't you watch it the past month when I've been mentioning to fucking watch it? I first mentioned it when I fucking was sitting in a bar with Adrian. I mentioned it to you to fucking watch it.
I hate streaming shit. I hate streaming.
All right, that's a good transition. All right, well, we're going to talk about One Cut of the Dead now.
See you later, loser.
You can see another car just swipe and hit.
Oh. Uh-oh.
All right,
good.
All right, One Cut of the Dead. Fuck, dude, I fucking love this movie. It's in my top five of this year.
Yeah,
it might even be higher, like high on that list, and it might even be like high in just like my decade list. I fucking loved it. I had a grin the entire fucking movie, and I was stunned they fucking pulled off that 37-minute fucking
one. Yeah, right.
I don't know why. The dumbest thing I've done this year is. I kept hearing One Cut of the Dead, One Cut of the Dead. I never understood what I was saying though. So like
One Cut of the Dead.
Yeah. So literally 10 minutes in, I'm like, oh fuck, they haven't cut. They really have. They haven't actually cut.
It's one of those where if you go into it not aware it's a comedy,
right.
Like that whole first 40 minutes, you're like, oh, this is some really shitty acting and whatnot. Like, no, wow, this is really bad. And then when it makes that transition, you're like, oh my God, this is the best movie ever.
No, like, I love it because it puts you in there and you're going with it. And it's so fast paced, you're just going with it. But some weird stuff happens here or there. And you're just like, I don't know if that was meant to be or I don't know. That was weird, but whatever.
That's what I was thinking,
like,
too.
Like, when one of the zombies starts doing fucking karate moves and shit.
Yeah, that, or when he's doing the weird zombies, like, just, like, chilling like that, and you're just like...
The first time where I was just like, this is weird, it was the mother character who plays, like, the makeup artist or whatever, in the beginning, is, like, talking about something, and then something bangs against the door, and they look. And you could feel like the awkwardness.
Right.
It's like,
and they start talking about weird stuff.
And that's the first time where I was just like,
and they go off topic after that.
And then the boom operator.
Yeah. And then they explain it later.
Yeah. Yeah. No. That was like one of the prime examples because that happens. And they start going like off topic where they're like, so what are your hobbies or something like that? And it was really weird. And in my head, I was like, I guess trying to like lower the tension of everything that was been going on lately or something.
Yeah,
I don't know. I guess.
And then I love the beauty of that. How it just. It was one of those things where it's like, especially going back, you know, when they're going through the second half of the movie, it's like, oh, that whole thing was just, you know, a one-off. And then when she has the axe and she's actually trying to kill the girl and she does the fucking move, like, oh my god, the one-off thing isn't a one-off. It's a fucking callback.
It's so good that it's like 37 minutes of just like awesome cinematography. And then after that, it's just a bunch of payoffs. Like, here's this, here's that, and everything from the fucking, the second the first act ends, it really is the third act. When the third act hits, it just pays off everything in the first two-thirds of the movie. It was incredible. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to look for a physical copy of that, because I need it. It's just a fucking good movie.
Great movie.
Ugh.
And then I also like what I also like was, you know, the whole second and third act is great, but I love the credits just because it gives you the little behind the scene of them doing the one shot.
Yeah, I was hoping that
it's like really interesting to see not just like how they're doing it, but even like how they take little breaks, like how they'd even get a drink of water.
Yeah, no, I thought that was, I really want a full thing of that, honestly. I want someone else filming the entire thing of that.
Just the behind the scenes, I'm sure.
And then like where it's like you see one of the guys falls, you see the other guy drop, so it doesn't like screw up the shot or anything.
Yeah, but I was telling someone who watches that with me who isn't into movies, where they were like, so what's like the big deal of one cut? I had to keep reiterating like every like 10 or like 5 or 10 minutes, like, by the way, if they fuck up here, they're starting the entire thing over.
I
keep reiterating that. I'm like, that's why it's so weird. Like, people who don't watch movies, they probably didn't notice it, right? Like, it's kind of just, it's so you're just in the zone. I'm like, notice how like once I was pointing out like second act, because it was cool because like you kind of get like jazz like knowing about film, you know, like kind of like getting in the background of it. It was fun to kind of geek out a little bit. But I was like, notice how everything's like cutting in here there, like quick cuts here there. The entire thing on minute 35 of 37. If someone's in the shot, if someone's in the wrong line, if someone misses the choreography, they're starting from the first fucking second of this movie.
Yeah.
Fucking nuts. And it was a fucking... Oh, my God. Everything was so awesome in it. Everything paid off. I fucking loved every second of it.
Right.
And I love that they were, like, meta with it, too. We're like, oh, we have to make this a one-cut thing. And they had to do the improv. There's, like, improv... My favorite part that I did not understand when I was watching it, and I love that I got paid off because I forgot about it, was when you saw the zombie leg for a second.
Yeah.
Look up, and I thought about it. I was like, we never got paid off to that. And then when I got excited, when I saw it, I was like, oh shit, what's going to happen? Why did I see that shot? Pick up the axe.
Yeah,
3 or 4 times when the director would just randomly pop up.
God, he was so good.
I really want to know.
He was so good.
I really wanted.
Good.
He was so good. Yeah. I really like at the end of that. By the end of the fake movie in the beginning, I was already like, something's going on, obviously. But it's just like, obviously, this is like some movie or something. I wonder how they got tied in. But at the end of that, there was just like a shot of the girl screaming. And it's just like
it was
a
so
whole
long.
Minute.
It was so long. And
I was
it,
just like, yeah, this is.
But
this is,
but see,
like,
no, see, when I was explaining that to
her, I wanted to see what would happen there.
When I was explaining that to her, in my mind, I'll try to process like as if like, okay, maybe they're trying to be practical and it's just fucking up. I was like, well, see, that the reason why it's taking so long is they're like trying to actually like they're making the scene behind them. That's why it's acting so. But it's funny because even in my head, when I was explaining that, I was like, this is like still way too long. Like what?
Yeah, it's way too. Yeah. Long. It's just like her scream.
And I love that they were pointing that out. And then, yeah, they're in the background, like they're like, this is really long.
Yeah, it's just like they had to make a movie, 30-minute movie, live, and it had to be one cut.
Yeah, like, yeah, with the executives going, is it supposed to go this long? And then just the one producer, like, yeah, this is all the rage these days.
And then right after that, when they're building the pyramid, and that's when they're doing the whole.
I love that scene. It's so good.
Oh man, and it also made sense too because when the makeup artist got up and started screaming.
yeah. When she got up, he was like, "That was
that,
real."
That was
they had
so
to choke her out.
Everything was so fucking good. Like I loved every second of it. Oh man, I couldn't be so more happy with the movie. Like that was awesome.
Also, I know you've mentioned it a few times. I think that movie had more pay like. Not just good, but in general, more payoffs than I've seen in, like, any other movie.
If there's any question, any question you have, why the fuck the film is like that in the beginning, they explain it. Why does that guy look kind of weird?
Why is that guy like kind of zoned out? And I was like, maybe he's like really like traumatized from everything going on right now. No, he just had to shit.
Yeah, he had to shit really badly. The one guy that gets puked on was really
that was my reaction when he was drunk. I was like, oh shit, that's actual puke.
I love the diarrhea, because it cuts to him going out, cuts to them filming, it cuts back to him just with his pants down, squatting in a fucking
He's
bush.
Embarrassed.
Going, like, really? I'm sorry, I'm so sorry.
I can name every single part of that I fucking loved. When they knock over the camera guy, he's like just stuck. And then they had to get the other girl. And that explained why the camera quality or the way it was filmed was so different from the first part.
Yeah, it was so different.
It was a lot more zoom in and stuff like that. I was like, oh shit.
He's trying to be a film student. You're like, I gotta really show all the emotions and shit. It's like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Everything. I guess we didn't say it. We said it a little bit, but the director, every time, just.
Director's great.
Just action! Yes.
In the beginning, I was loving it.
Because it's when she's running up to the roof.
Yeah.
So he just comes out, action! And then the fucking wife just kicks him in the nuts and keeps going.
Yeah, you see her like fucking kung fu kicking people and everything. You're like, oh, that's pretty cool. Though she actually was doing that.
My favorite one is when he opens the door to the van and he's like, he throws a zombie in there and he just screams, get that bitch! He's like, god damn. That was improvised too. I love the whole idea is that he's screaming at these people because he doesn't like them in real life. Like
he slaps the actor.
Yeah,
he gets upset about it behind the scenes. Like, you hit me. No one's hit me. And then the wife comes in and slaps him too.
Yeah, I love that he doesn't like these actors. He doesn't. That's why he's like fucking really like. Even the character's just like, man, he's really good at this improv. I'm like, I don't know if it's improv. I don't think he likes it.
God, he was so good
at the very beginning. They're like, the one's like, oh yeah, you can get serious. It's okay. It's fine. And then he just fucking berates her into the ground. And he goes back into the fucking sound room. And they're like, oh, that was some great acting. I didn't know you could act like that. It's just, oh yeah. Yeah. Just trying to convince everyone. Yeah. That was acting.
Hold on really quick. Kyle, you got a little spill there on your beard?
Oh yeah. Hey, you saw Robert Pattinson in the store. Decided to help
him finish off. I should have left it go for as long as I could have, but
yeah, you see how much gets on.
Anyway, no, but it was such a fun time, and that was, and
water bottle. Wow.
Oh yeah, chug it. You won't chug it. No balls.
Chug it. If
no
you don't
balls.
Chug it, fuck you. You still have a little bit on your beard. Anyway, what were you gonna say, Adrian?
No, I can go on and on about literally every single thing that was in the movie because
everything was great. Just the way it paid off, like this. I will say this: this was probably the hardest review I had to write because I just didn't want to spoil anything of it. Like,
you gotta go in blind if you really want to enjoy it. But
yeah, I couldn't. I had to like explain it like if it was actually a real zombie movie. And I could only describe certain things in ways like, yeah, if you have a love for filmmaking, indie filmmaking, you're really going to appreciate this movie. That's all I could say because I didn't want to spoil any of it. The trailer, even like in the beginning, it's just like, if you ever saw the trailer, I watched it after, at least the one I watched, says like in the trailer in the beginning, it's like, spoiler, you should just fucking watch the movie, bro. Don't watch this trailer because you can't fucking make a trailer for this without spoiling what it's actually about.
I'm legit then, like this
all
is...
the synopsis I've seen for it were all similar and saying that was basically like the synopsis was a bunch of people getting attacked by zombies while trying to film a zombie movie. And I'm like, oh, okay, that actually sounds interesting.
I'm serious. Like, this is literally one of my favorite movies. Like, it shot up on my list. Like, everything about it, I love the first part's just fun time. Second part's a little behind the scenes, and third part's like, let's just pay off everything you just fucking enjoyed and just like crank it up a little bit. Watching a whole second movie, even though you're watching the exact stuff that you just watched on film again. And then I'd watch it three times. I would watch the first cut again, the whole thing, what they were doing. I'd watch the fake behind the scenes they were doing, and I'd watch the real behind the scenes they were doing, because all of it is fucking incredible.
Yeah.
I know it's an obvious comparison, but personally with this, I compare, it's basically just, I love it as much as I love Shaun of the Dead.
True.
No, a lot of people say this is like the best one of those movies. Zombie comedy since
then. Oh, yeah, it's definitely the best horror comedy since then. But Shaun of the Dead is one movie, one of those like horror comedies that I will watch endlessly and I never get tired of it. I still laugh at the same jokes and I still love the same shots. And this is one of those movies where I'm just going to feel, you know, no matter how many times I watch it, I'm never going to get tired of it. I'm always going to love it. There's always going to be parts I love.
I feel like this might be a yearly movie for me because I just, everything about
mm-hmm.
it.
Yeah,
it's absolutely. A great one, especially for somebody that's not.
It's a quick watch,
not,
too.
Yeah, it's an hour and a half. It's just like, it's perfect. It's the first half is, I mean, first half, first 30-something minutes is just the horror part. Some people I could see being like squirming through that because some of it is bad, but there's a purpose to it.
But I like, feel like, actually, I feel like
when I reviewed it for the site I review stuff for,
shout them out.
They shout out crprights.com. He got sent a screener for it, and in the screener they said, hey, stick with it for the first 30 minutes, please. They actually gave warnings to people that are reviewing it, please stick with it. Because I guess they get so many reviewers that watch a little bit, and they say, "Nah, I have
to." And they're like, "Oh, this acting's bad and whatnot."
Yeah, it's bad. It's on purpose. So please, like, we're we're spoiled.
It's bad acting, but there's a reason for it.
Yeah,
but yeah, later on, I don't even see how people would freak out. It's like it's still one cut, like
because it's kind of slow. Yeah, but people, like you said to yourself, you said that some people don't realize that it's one cut. You said
that, no, I mean, I'm saying critics. So if you're being a critic and you're doing that, it's like I feel like you should like give it a lot of leeway to be like, oh, well, if there's
some. There's a lot of critics out there that have to watch like tons of movies every day. They get sent movies every day.
Oh, man. I don't know how you legit, if you be in the movies, can't enjoy the first 30 minutes. It's so much fun. It's just a fun ride.
They probably watch a lot of horror movies.
It's also one of those things where if you're seeing like acting like that and you think, okay, you know, you're 20 minutes in, you go, all right, I got another at least hour of this. You're like, all right, I'm out.
Other movies to review, you know, like
yeah. So warning like, was a good idea. I'm not liking this so far. I'm not gonna you just gotta stick with it for 30, 40 minutes, and believe me, you'll understand everything.
That's fair. I did spoil myself a little bit in the beginning because I was like 15 minutes in, I was like, this, how long is this cut? So I looked and I was like, One Cut of the Dead, and I looked up like One Cut. And it said like three things you should know about One Cut of the Dead, and I only saw the first two things, which was first act is one cut, and I was like, okay, so there's more shit after this, after the credits of the cut, and then they said, this is actually a feel good movie. I was like, okay, so it's going somewhere with it. That's all I need. It didn't spoil anything really, so it was fine with me.
Yeah.
But I forgot that second part immediately as soon as I just kept going. I just forgot about the second part. But
I would love to see another movie just with the characters, because I mean, not with the same gimmick, obviously, but just characters again. I love the director. I love his wife. I love just the whole family dynamic. There was a little bit of that in there.
They're trying to make an American remake of it.
Yeah, I heard.
I don't really care about it. I wish they just like advertise the fuck out of this one.
Well, no, yeah. I'd like it if they made it almost into a franchise where it's that family. But each movie is them having to do a new movie for a new new genre. Yeah, they have to do an action movie, and then an adventure, and then like a drama. Like
I can see it getting old though.
The first movie did really well.
Like Chris said, not all one cut, but like
I'm saying is I don't want to be burned out by them. I want to like have just enough. If they have to do another one, cool it. But I'm like, I like this family so much. I love it. This is in and out. I got what I got with it, you know.
Yeah, but I wouldn't mind a sequel. Kyle's dying.
Yeah, same. I'd be perfectly happy with that.
Kyle just got possessed for a second. You saw that?
Yeah. Well, what was happening there? Good ass ice cream.
He said sequel. And he went. Oh.
He had a brain freeze of the dead or some shit. You okay, bro?
Climax of the dead, apparently.
But yeah, no. I
come Robert Pattinson to know that face.
Super happy with this movie. Incredibly happy with it. It's in my top five. It's going to be probably in contention for top three, maybe.
Yeah, it was really good. It's one of those movies that you should definitely get a Shudder account for. I would recommend at least getting
the free trial. I want to get the physical of it. Apparently there's a pre-order for it.
Yeah, it's not out yet, though. But if you want to watch it now, then Shudder's.
Oh, I just want the movie forever.
I know. I'm not talking to you, though.
Talk to me.
I mean, we already spoiled it.
Talk to me.
I hate talking to you.
Oh!
All right. Yeah, you really, when you put it up, you really should put with the timestamp for it, like heavy spoiler warning.
I'm gonna put like in the timestamps, Do not.
I'll call it a spoiler talk anyway, so. All these are spoiler talks. So.
Oh, yeah, but then, you know, spoilers. Even spoilers. This one really gets ruined by the spoilers.
Yeah.
Can you edit something at the beginning of our One Cut of the Dead to say, like, if you haven't watched it, fucking watch it.
Skip to whatever the next time
stamp is. I have timestamps on it, but yeah. All right.
Well, no, I'm saying skip to the next one. That way they avoid it.
Cool. Let's talk about Antlers.
Antlers.
We're almost done.
Yeah. Okay. Right. Antlers. Looks pretty good.
All right, I'm excited.
So, it's one of those great trailers where it shows, you know, it shows a lot while showing nothing at the same time.
It was the same. The first trailer came out a few months ago, and I don't think we talked about it, but it was really good. It was this trailer, except more in like a fairy tale way, because the kid's like telling this like fairy tale, like once there was a kid and a parent or whatever, and he's just like kind of retelling the story of what the fuck's going on with this I guess this infected something. I don't even know. That's why. You okay there?
Okay.
All right.
Anyway.
Jesus Christ. Fucking destroyed my flow completely with that fucking stupid shit. Anyway. The first trailer was great. The second trailer I really liked too, yeah. But the first one was like a huge surprise. It was like what the fuck is going on? And it was like really creepy and ended with like a what the fuck is that? And this one was the same thing. It was creepy. You know, it was like meth demons in it. That's cool.
Shows and then, a bored person that ended a fucking close up of some monstrous fucking licked or Wendigo or some monstrous Wendigo. Shit.
That's what everybody's thinking. It's like I think it's a Wendigo. It's like. Now, we don't get too many movies about Wendigo, so
yeah, I won a long time ago. But we've had with them is fucking Pet Cemetery.
Yeah,
and that they never even showed them.
Yeah, we like hear them. Like there was a movie called Wendigo that came out like 20 years ago. That was heard was really good. But yeah, I mean if it's Wendigo, that's cool. I mean I'd rather it just be like a whatever, like I'm hoping it's like an infection or some shit. Like I just want it to be that, like some Last of Us shit.
Honestly, what I
you
love
go
the
crazy,
most
like throw bone, like these bone fucking things out of your head and shit. You just fucking turn into a monster. That'd be cool with me.
I think honestly the best part about this trailer is just except for like near the end, there's like no dialogue whatsoever.
Yeah, no, that's what I was
saying. That made it's just so much creepier and so much better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's no dialogue until the end, and it's always good. I always like
it. I'm usually cautious going into horror movies. This one I'm actually already really excited for.
Yeah, it looks good. Shout out to Antlers.
No, it looks cool. Who's putting that out again?
Fox Searchlight. Which means Disney, which is weird.
Which means Kyle can't watch that. Also, Kyle can't watch Terminator this weekend.
No.
You're not allowed to. If I see you there, I'm fucking
beat. Yeah, because Paramount's putting it out, but International is 20th Century Fox, which means Disney.
So thus not put out by Fox in America. So thus that doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter. You said you wouldn't even watch Pixar or anything distributed or anything.
Yeah, also, it was after Rise of Skywalker. After that, I'm done.
Well, no, you said that was the only movie you're making exception for, but all right.
Oh, after that, I'm done.
You're not going to see Alita Battle Angel 2? That'll never be made. So don't worry
also,
about
by the way, also, by the way, I said anything non-Fox from Disney I would not watch. I will watch shit from Fox, even though it goes to Disney. Because, you know.
Yeah, because your $10 don't matter. Yeah, you're kind of a hypocrite. I don't know, man.
No.
I'd stick to my guns.
Well, no, that's extreme. It is hypocritical. You're going, I'm not going to watch any of this stuff except for most of the stuff I usually watch.
It's going to come to a point where I can't watch any movie because Disney owns it.
Probably long dead before
you watch outside of Pixar and
Star Wars, all the soy boy Disney cuck shit I'm not watching.
Why is it all soy boy? Like it's like Anything
Soy Boys. You don't watch anything.
Toy Story 4 is for Soy Boys.
That's all their fucking movies are for. And fucking single mothers. It's sad and pathetic.
Yeah, Toy Story 4 is for single mothers and Soy Boys.
Definitely is for Soy Boys, I'll tell you that.
You fucking loved it. I guess you're a... You mean you said they fucking made another masterpiece. I can't believe they did it. You said that in our video. The fuck you talking about? Oh, now because it's been four months now. Fuck it. He was just like, oh, it's old now. I don't care.
Kevin Smith movie.
Christ. I bet Ad Astra in like a month you'd be like, oh, that movie sucked. Like even though you're like, oh, that's Kino. That's Kino, guys. That Kino.
Go back to talk about your Kevin Smith movie, all right?
What the fuck, Kevin Smith? What? That's a Toy Story and fucking Ad Astra. What the fuck, Kevin
Smith?
No,
it's a fucking stupid trailer you're talking about.
No, that's Tusk. You think of you cock?
Oh.
Yeah. We're talking about
shout out to Antlers. You look good. We're
Antlers isn't Kevin Smith. What are you high?
Speaking of Disney, let's talk about
from the guy that did. It's from the guy that did Black Mass. Ooh. Fucking Black Mass with Johnny Depp, where he had the bald cap on.
Yeah, that piece of shit.
Yeah, that was a good movie. I liked it.
Just kind of let's talk about Disney. We should talk about Mandalorian.
It's no Donnie Brasco. Let me tell you.
Oh yeah, the best one.
Yeah, that's a good movie. Donnie Tabasco. That's a good movie.
Raise your hand if you're getting Disney Plus.
I have
honestly,
Verizon.
Since I'm a Verizon member, I guess
get
I
it. Yeah, Kyle, raise your hand, Kyle. Raise your hand, Kyle.
Raise this guy to shit.
Soy, I love Disney. I love Star Wars. I love
There's your thumbnail. There's your thumbnail right there.
Hi! Who's excited for Rise of fucking bitch stupid cunt?
There's our fucking our intro to the fucking podcast. That's the fucking intro right there.
The Rise of Bitch Cunt Skywalker. Where he said I'm gonna that one. That sounds good.
Yeah, take a drink of that.
Fuck
Kyle
Star Wars. I want to hear about the rise of bitch cut.
Yeah, bitch cut. That's my favorite. Spelled B-I-C-H. No, it's just cunt. I can't think of.
Oscar
come
Isaac
with a K.
Trash.
What'd you say?
What has Oscar Isaac been in other than trash? Because John Boyega hasn't been in shit. Daisy Ridley's been in. And see, that's exactly my point, because he actually was in good shit. But what,
he was in Annihilation, but he didn't like that, so.
He's in Annihilation for
Oscar
less than
Isaac, Kyle.
5 minutes.
Kyle. He was what? Just in Adam's Family.
That's what I just said. It's trash.
I know, but you said it was trash. I thought you loved it.
No.
All right, put your hand down and reverse everything you just did.
Yeah. Yeah, just go in reverse.
Oh, Kyle, in pose, can you put that and just... Put it in reverse.
Reverse you. Yeah, right now, put it in reverse. What you just did. The whole rant where everybody's probably looking at you right now in this parking lot because you're screaming.
Mom, there's a homeless guy in that car screaming.
In that shitty car screaming.
He's screaming at his dashboard. Something's wrong.
He's eating a Choco Taco. Where the fuck?
He has cum on his beard.
That's what the nine-year-old said? It's definitely Robert Pattinson's. I can smell it from here.
All right, speaking of that, let's talk about Mandalorian.
All right. Did you watch this trailer, Kyle?
No.
You have Disney Plus. You're buying it. You're hyped.
I'm not buying it.
You're gonna watch it with everyone, man.
Yeah. I think it looks great. I really do.
This looks fucking amazing. I also love the fact that after all this time, finally fucking gave someone armor that can actually reflect shit and not immediately die.
Yeah, that was nice. Which is good. And he gets shot once, and he's just like, what the fuck? And he just shoots that dude.
Well, there's one, he gets shot in the shoulder, nothing happens. And then when he has his fucking badass kill as he's walking out the door, he gets shot in the shoulder, just bounces right the fuck off.
Well, that makes sense. I mean, it's a TV show. Like, in a movie, like, it's 2 hours... I mean, there's going to be times where they're going to be in trouble, obviously. There's going to be times where they're going to have to get hurt. But at least you could say it's a two-hour movie, so you have to be a little bit fast and, like, you know, not show everybody getting hurt all the time and, like, have to heal up and shit or whatever. So here now you have to just show. You have 8 hours. And just like, yeah, show his ass getting shot up. I'm sure it's still hurt, but he's not dead when he got shot in that fucking armor. Yeah, and I'm glad we got to hear how he talks. He just sounds like Pedro Pascal, so that's good.
I hope they, you know, he only said like three words, but I hope they keep him like that, where
yeah, good.
He doesn't say much, or when he does, he keeps it short. You know, he keeps it short and he speaks slowly.
Yeah,
like it just makes him seem like so much more methodical and badass.
Yeah. And I mean, the sets, everything looks really good. The cast is crazy. Like, you got Carl Weathers. You got fucking
Bill Burr.
Werner Herzog. Bill fucking Burr. I thought he was just going to be, like, a comedic scene, because I knew he was going to be in it. I thought he was just going to have, like,
I thought
he shows up in this one fucking, like, gunning down motherfuckers. I'm like, what the
fuck? Yeah, I thought he was going to be somewhat, maybe, like, voicing a character. I didn't think he'd be on screen. And then all of a sudden, he's there fucking tri-wielding guns, because he's got attached to his shoulder. I'm like, fucking hell, what's this fucking Predator shit he's pulling?
Whoa. I wasn't expecting that. I thought he'd just be like, hey, what's up? I thought he's gonna do his Philly rant or something.
He's like,
yeah. hey, what's up?
Now,
hey, I don't know why he's that at all, too. That doesn't even know what he talks like. But, he doesn't sound like that at all. But, anyway. You go on a rant about women, like he always does. Most of his comedy is like, it's just like, women are overrated. Oh my god.
Or like, why women always argue?
Well, the amount of shit he says in like, his comedy, I'm so surprised he's even in a Disney-owned property like this.
Yeah. I was actually watching some of his stand-up today, and I forget which special it was, really, but it just starts off
Let
with...
It go.
I don't know, but it starts off with pedophiles, you know? Just like, back in the day, you see a little kid up here, you're like, hey, what's up, Timmy? Pat him on the head. Now they walk by, you're like, nope, don't fucking touch me. I'm not aroused. Don't fucking get near me.
Yeah. Looper's great, man. Yeah. Breaking Bad makes sense. Yeah.
What?
Breaking Bad, Bill Burr being in Breaking Bad? He didn't even know.
Him and Huel, dude. Yeah, he's lost. He had a mental breakdown when he did that.
I don't think he even knows who Bill Burr is.
Oh, I don't. He sounds like some hat.
He was in Breaking Bad. He played I forgot his name.
He played Huel's friend.
Yeah, Huel's friend that he negotiated for the gas station or whatever. Didn't he say like there was like, I remember that scene where he talked to the guy with the big eyebrows.
Right.
Wait, say again.
He went to Ted's house where Ted fucking...
Yeah. And then he ran and broke his own neck. He was there, him and Huel. I always remember that scene. He was like, and he just tripped over that fucking rug and... It was like, great stuff. Anyway, it's spoilers for Breaking Bad. Right? No big spoilers, to be honest. Mm-hmm. But anyway, Bill Burr is in the trailer, and I'm surprised that he looks like he's going to be badass in it. I'm sure watching that's like...
Bill back.
Bill Burr.
Bill is back.
Feel the burn.
Burr. If you say it slow enough, it might be funny. Anyway.
All right, that's the Mandalorian.
That was a great trailer, though. It was really good, and we don't have to wait too long. 2 weeks until it's out, so.
Disney Plus.
We can watch that. You can watch that, and then the Lady and the Tramp movie.
Oh, yeah, Kyle, you ready to fucking watch that with us?
Yeah, we're going to watch the Lady and the Tramp movie together.
Like for Christmas.
Yeah. No, for whatever day it comes out. Disney Plus day.
Alright. Last thing we're going to talk about, then we're out of here. The Grudge.
Don't care. Oh, yeah, definitely don't care. Alright. I don't like The Grudge. I thought Ju-on, the original, it was fine.
The original was good. Part of that was because, I wouldn't say anthology, but it was like an episodic.
Yeah.
And that's what really made it good was, you know, you'd have 15, 20 minutes with a person or a family that would move on to someone else. And
it was still like a whole story, but it was just like it kept switching.
Yeah, there was an overall story, but yeah. But it was just, and then when America tried doing it, it was just...
Sarah Michelle Gellar!
Yeah, they...
Fuck.
It's just, it didn't... It lost a lot of it when they just tried to do it, you know, as a movie with the whole... Oh shit! That then became fucking spinoffs and shit.
Yeah, he had the creepy voice, he got the cow, and then the cow. What the fuck? The kid that can meow. It was just like generic shit that was not even generic yet, but just felt generic. It's like we had The Ring, which was actually a really creepy movie. That was actually a movie, like a legit movie, a mystery at points. where like the whole idea of the ring isn't just like creepy girl come out of the TV. That doesn't even happen until the end of the movie. You don't even see that until the last 10 minutes. It's like, what's up, man? Get you back away from the camera. Huh? I don't want to see your disgusting fucking skin. All right. So.
He's tired. Look at him. He wants to go home.
He's beautiful. If he wanted to go home, he could have did it in the 2 hours before he. Fuck that. Wait,
Kyle. Joke's on you. He's already home.
Yeah, he's already home. I'm already home. What was that from? Is that a movie? That's a line from a movie.
Wizard of Oz.
Oh, yeah, Wizard of Oz. And she There's says, no fuck, like, fuck oh, having these slippers.
Oh, shit.
I'm staying here with the scarecrow. Anyway, you know, I'm going to take as long as possible to talk about this. So I just to see if he will keep this this face the entire time.
I hope it's all walking in front of his car right now.
You can, cause there's also a couple of quick pieces of news I want to touch on, so we can drag it out a bit longer.
Yeah, I want to talk about my tax return and
your new Patreon?
My Patreon that I just decided to make 5 seconds ago.
Kickstarter Patreon Indiegogo.
Yeah, and also I want to talk about...
Yeah, he has it. It's on me.
There goes my Patreon. Anyway, this movie looks like it could be fine, maybe. It's just weird that it's... First of all, it's Sony, so right there, I'm already like negative 5 points right now. And it's also like 2 months before it comes out, which that's never good when they have a trailer like...
And then they also said this is tight. It's not a remake. It's tied into both the American and Japanese movies.
Which that could just mean anything.
They're trying to actually like connect all three movies together. It's gonna be fucking confusing as hell.
Which is weird because there's already a third Grudge movie that came out in America that went straight to DVD. Nobody fucking watched. I did though. Yeah. It was a fucking turd. It was better than the second one though. I'll give it that because the second one I fucking hated. By the way, if you want to laugh, go. We always shout out Mega 64. Go watch Rocco from Mega 64 talk about the Grudge 2 trailer. It's always funny when he talks about it.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah. Anyway, this trailer was fine. I don't know. It had like obvious jump scares, but it has a like, good cast. It looks like it could be interesting. It looks a little bit more grittier than most shitty, like low budget horror movies nowadays, where it's just like a bunch of teenagers or whatever, or like maybe we follow a little girl or something like that, like an Annabelle movies or some shit. This one looks like it, like we're following a detective and stuff, and we also follow John Cho's character. Who I love.
Yeah, I was gonna say this has turned into now the horror movies have gone from we're following a bunch of teenagers to we're following John Cho doing X.
Yeah, so I mean it's fine. I like John Cho, so I wish Cal Penn was in it though. Just have a Harold and Kumar versus the Grudge movie. Let's see that. That'd be amazing. I'm sorry. It'd be like they should do a Harold and Kumar show that's like Scooby Doo, where they have like
oh my god,
like guest appearances. That'd be amazing.
I imagine it'd be something along the lines of like fucking Mike Tyson's Mysteries.
Oh yeah, that'd be amazing. They'll never do it. I think John Cho's too much of a kind of serious actor now. He's still doing the Grudge though. But he's in the Cowboy Bebop show, so.
Anyway. Well, he was until broke his ankle. It's like, all right, we're done for 9 months.
Yeah. I mean, he's still gonna be in it. They filmed like up to episode 4, I think they said. Yeah. So they can't like restart. Oh, his fucking ass is broken down. You gotta start over. But yeah, the trailer is fine. It was just like there's too many jump scares, but I like the look of it, and I like that it's rated R. I know that's silly to say, like, oh fuck, I'm already more excited because it's rated R, but no. Studio nowadays really cares about an R rating for horror movies. There'll be times like the Annabelle movies because they know it will sell because it's Annabelle. But right. Like the last couple Grudge movies didn't do well, and they came out like 10 years ago. So it's not like there's an established brand, but nobody fucking really cares about the Grudge anymore. I mean, the last one to come out was that The Ring versus Grudge movie. That was a Japanese movie, obviously, and went to Shudder. Like it was Shudder, like,
yeah.
But the last American one went straight to DVD, and nobody watched it. And that was like 10 years ago, at least. So, where you have Annabelle, all those movies do well, so they can make it rated R. I'm hoping it goes fucked up. Also, it's produced by Sam Raimi, so
I'm
hoping that means we could get some Evil Dead shit. I was getting Evil Dead like remake vibes, like hard.
Yeah, that's what I like whenever Sam's involved with a horror movie, because even if it's not great, you know you'll get those.
you'll at least get one real gory scene. Yeah. And not just gory, but like gory and like with that classic horror that you don't get much anymore.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I'm hoping we get some fucked up stuff in it. And if it ends up being a fun time, that'll immediately be better than any of the horror movies from the past few years that started the year off. Like Escape Room was barely even a horror movie. I think last year was the last Insidious movie. There's always like a shitty horror movie to start off.
No, I think wasn't last year. It was last year or the year before was Truth or Dare.
When was that?
Truth or Dare was April last year, I think.
Close enough.
I don't know why I remember that, but I'm pretty sure it was April. Movie.
Hey, do the face score.
He's like, which face? I do a lot of faces.
I can't do it. Help. Hey.
Kyle's doing it.
Edit my face in. Yeah, there you go. That face. Dude, now, Kyle, right here. Edit your face to make it look like the demon Pazuzu, whatever his name was, in Truth or Dare. Make his go all the way up like that.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. You saw Truth or Dare.
No. I saw a trailer of it before you were never really here, which is funny.
Watch Truth or Dare next week, Kyle. Tell me how you like it.
That's weird.
Ew, I don't want to watch any more movies you guys recommend.
I don't want to watch
any
more movies.
You didn't watch One Cut of the Dead, and you didn't mind Bay of Blood, so what the fuck? And you wanted to see Audition.
You liked
that too.
The Witch.
And you liked The Witch, even though you already saw it before. Don't fucking give me that stare,
you also
bro.
Fucking love The Thing, so
what the fuck is he doing?
he's going to the lighthouse.
No, you have to really scream, bro. It was this.
I think that's it. Unless anyone has.
Well, a couple.
You didn't even say anything, Adrian.
Yeah, you
watch it.
Oh, well, there you go.
Watch what?
The Grudge.
Well, couple.
I watched it. Let's make them. Let's make them quick. Shit.
Yeah.
I make them quick if Kyle stops.
All right.
Couple quick things. They're getting they announced that the Wonder Woman trailer is coming out December 8th.
I saw that.
Because that's when the Brazil has their big convention. Mm. I don't know. Did any of you guys, I posted in the chat, did any of you look at the Sonic redesign?
Yeah we talked about that on the game podcast like a week ago. It leaked before that, and then it got leaked again when you posted it. And we're like, well, there you go. That's official. I said, Adrian.
I talked about that on a game podcast when it's
because it's a video game.
It's a movie.
Yeah, it's a movie based on a video game. If there was no video game about Sonic, then there would be no movie about Sonic. You fucking idiot, dumb fuck piece of shit.
It could have been.
Go get a house. Go get a house.
Get a house. I'm in a house. I'm in a domicile, bitch.
Yeah, my asshole.
All right, next story.
Disney said that earlier this month, they, you know, for the 40th anniversary, they had Aliens play in theaters. Disney said that's the last time any classic Fox movies are going to be playing in theaters anymore.
Didn't they make the exception of Rocky Horror?
They said there's a couple of exceptions, but the exceptions is anything that's already been announced. So if like Fathom Events has announced it, they're keeping it in. After that, they're done.
Disney's a bunch of cocks. Obviously, it's so they could put it on their fucking streaming site, but fuck them.
Except they're not even doing that.
They will.
Why is that? I don't get why that's a.
How much you want to bet? No, how much you want to bet? Like next year, you'll see like Alien up there for October or
no,
something.
No, I get that, but why is that a factor in them not wanting to do like the theatrical? I feel like that's just an extra.
Because then people could be like, "Oh, it's in theaters. Why would I pay there?"
Yeah, people are gonna go. Oh, so the only way I can watch it is to go in the streaming service.
Well, the article explained that the reason why they're putting their Fox movies in like a vault is because it's like, oh. They think that if an old movie is playing in a theater on a screen, they think, oh, a Marvel movie or a Star Wars movie or one of our other movies could be playing on that, not some old movie. Yeah. That in the article from Matt Zoller Sites, because I read it, that's what they say.
None of the other sites that I've read the article on.
None of the other sites. The main fucking article where all this shit came from fucking said it. Fuck it. I don't give a shit. It's what it fucking said.
Oh, no.
Upset. Well,
we
should
the amount of times he's not upset. That would be a...
Well, he's going to get upset because the fucking Star Wars and Disney news ain't stopping anytime soon. D&D pulled out of fucking Star Wars trilogy. They pulled out of that and they went, fuck, they got asked why, like, why are you pulling out? It's like, oh, we're working with Netflix.
Nah, I don't know, Kyle, first of all, Kyle doesn't even give a shit because he doesn't even know who the fuck D&D is.
Dungeons and Dragons?
Yeah, exactly. He doesn't. Do you know who they are?
No. D&D?
It's the guys that they're the showrunner for Game of Thrones, and nobody likes them. Because they fucked up Game of Thrones. So
yeah. So they were set to do another Star Wars trilogy movies, and they just backed out to go to Netflix.
What I think happened is that Disney saw how bad Gemini Man flopped because one of those fucking idiots wrote it. So
did they really?
I
forgot which one. I don't care. I think it was Benny Offer.
This fucking industry.
He was one of like three people, to be fair, but still, they just saw Gemini Man huge flop because Game of Thrones did really well viewership wise.
David Benioff.
And even though nobody liked it, really, I'm sure when it comes out on Blu-ray, everybody's going to buy that fucking Blu-ray. Oh, it's the final season. Got to get it. Yeah.
And then
Game of Thrones?
Game of Thrones. They'll buy it. Everybody, here's my unboxing.
Yeah, I really don't want to. I that's the one. And
you're going to buy it then.
No, I really don't want to. I really don't.
Why not?
Well,
I'd rather tell my future kids, hey, this is a great show. You know, the creators died right before the final season came out, so use your imagination.
Tragic plane crash that also claimed the life of Joaquin Phoenix.
On topic of Game of Thrones, just to wrap things up, HBO had their big one of their big calls today, which they gave out a fuck ton of news. That first Game of Thrones prequel, the Nightwalker one, or White Walker, that series, executives watched the pilot. They've canceled that show completely.
To be fair, apparently the pilot for Game of Thrones itself was actually pretty garbage, too.
Yeah, the first...
But they just watched this, and they immediately canceled everything, even though they're halfway through filming. And then announced that they're doing the Targaryen sequel that is prequel that's going straight to series, which is a bit weird how you go from we watch this pilot, cancel everything, to we have nothing on this, make it a full show. They said that HBO Max is coming out in May for $15 a month. Unless you have AT&T or HBO Now or HBO through DirecTV.
Net neutrality, baby.
another streaming service. Great.
So,
what?
So,
go watch the Red Letter Media Nerd Crew episode about.
There was an interview.
That's my fucking thoughts exactly.
There was an interview with D&D that where they mentioned like, so how do you guys feel about getting series? And they were like, man, we just couldn't believe he'd actually trust us.
Yeah. That's about right.
Yep.
And then the other two things from that, they had a few things, but the two real big ones is I want to know how much this cost them, but they got South Park for streaming.
Oh, that's cool.
Mm-hmm. Like the last number for that was like around $500 million, so I really want to know how much money they spent to get that. And then I forget the guy's name, but the guy who's the producer on all the CW, DC shows, Arrow, Flash, and all that, announced they're doing each episode's an hour long, but a full series for Green Lantern, which about fucking time.
When's Crisis on Infinite Earths happening?
That'll be.
They're gonna fuck it up anyway, so who cares?
That'll probably be about 3 weeks, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. So that's usually their holiday thing. But they've been saying this year that it's like basically like November through December is just basically going to be just everything's crisis.
Okay. All right. Anything else?
That's all.
I just got a news story here. Just breaking news. Kyle's a bitch. Not really breaking news.
Oh.
He came. Ooh. Do it.
Pour it on yourself.
You're, you're,
4 Hour Yourself.
Yeah.
Keep going. It's not, no, it's not done. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going.
Keep going.
Keep going. Keep going. Oh, oh, say Kumi. Say Kumi really loud when you're... Say Kumi.